Brain Rules by John Medina. From The Rule, one of this best-selling book, today I am going to share with you an unbelievable story. Picture this. A man, handcuffed and shackled, thrown into the Long Beach Harbor in California. But wait, there's more. This brave soul was attached to a floating cable, which in turn was connected to 70 boats, each carrying a passenger. Against all odds, battling strong winds and currents, this man swam 1.5 miles, towing all 70 boats behind him. And guess what? He did it to celebrate his 70th birthday. What a chap! You might be wondering who this incredible individual is. Well, let me introduce you to Jack LaLanne, the godfather of the American fitness movement. Now, Jack LaLanne isn't just a bodybuilder, he's a mental powerhouse too. If you ever have the pleasure of listening to an interview with him, you'll be blown away by his lightning-fast wit and improvisation skills. This man in his mid-90s is mentally sharp and full of energy, he once quipped to Larry King. I tell people I can't afford to die, it will wreck my image. And get this, he claims, he hasn't had dessert since 1929. Now that's some serious willpower. So, let's dive into the burning question. Is there a relationship between exercise and mental alertness? You bet there is. Our evolutionary history tells us that our ancestors were always on the move. When food became scarce, they had to roam around looking for new sources. They traversed rivers, deserts, jungles, and mountains without the aid of maps or modern tools. Their bodies and brains developed while constantly encountering new challenges. And it turns out that our cognitive skills flourished under these conditions of constant motion. But here's the exciting part. The benefits of exercise on the brain aren't just limited to our ancestors. Recent studies have shown that exercise can have a profound impact on our cognitive abilities. Those who lead an active lifestyle outperform couch potatoes in various mental tasks. Exercise improves long-term memory, reasoning, attention, problem-solving, and even fluid intelligence, which is the ability to think quickly and creatively. In other words, hitting the gym can make you sharper in the classroom and the workplace. Now, you might be wondering how much exercise you need to reap these brain-boosting benefits. Well, here's the good news. Even a simple activity like walking several times a week can do the trick. It's all about getting your body moving and your heart pumping. Just 30 minutes of aerobic exercise, 2 or 3 times a week, can work wonders for your cognitive performance. And if you add strength training to the mix, you'll get even more mental benefits. But that's not all. Exercise doesn't just keep your brain in top shape. It can also protect against age-related brain disorders. Studies have shown that an active lifestyle can cut your risk of dementia and Alzheimer's disease in half or more. Just participating in some form of exercise twice a week can make a significant difference. And if you want to reduce your chances of having a stroke, a 20-minute walk every day can lower your risk by a whopping 57%. So my friends, the evidence is clear. Exercise is not only good for your physical health, but also for your mental prowess. By incorporating regular exercise into your routine, you can enhance your cognitive abilities, boost your memory, sharpen your problem-solving skills, and increase your overall mental alertness. Now, you might be wondering how exercise actually achieves these remarkable effects on the brain. So here's the deal. When you get moving and grooving with some exercise, magical things start happening in your noggin. First off, it pumps up the blood flow to your brain, giving it a sweet dose of oxygen and all the good stuff it needs to function like a champ. Plus, it triggers the release of awesome chemicals like endorphins, dopamine, and serotonin that make you feel amazing and boost your brain power. But wait, there's more. Exercise actually helps your brain grow new neurons, especially in the memory-friendly hippocampus region. It's like planting little brain seeds and watching them sprout into smart and savvy cells. And the brain even produces this cool protein called BDNF, or brain-derived neurotrophic factor, that keeps your neurons happy and thriving. Now, here's the fun part. Exercise messes with neurotransmitters and hormones in your brain, like norepinephrine and cortisol. These guys control your attention, focus, and stress levels. When you exercise, they get all balanced out, giving you laser-like concentration and a chill attitude towards stress. It's like having your own personal brain, Zen master. So, what kind of exercise should you do? Anything that gets your heart pumping and your body moving. Run, swim, dance, play a sport, or do whatever floats your boat. The important thing is to break a sweat and challenge your ticker. And hey, don't forget about strength training too. Lifting weights or doing bodyweight exercises can give your brain an extra boost. Now here's the game plan. Try to get in at least 150 minutes of moderate aerobic exercise each week. Spread it out over a few days and don't be afraid to start small and work your way up. So my friends, it's time to get your exercise groove on. Pump up those brain muscles, unlock your full brain potential, and rock this thing called life. This information came to my attention through the book Brain Rules by John Medina. If you're eager to delve deeper into this topic, I highly recommend purchasing the book by clicking on the link provided in the description below. But if you're not a fan of reading books but still desire to gain insight from the best-selling personal development books, our channel offers an alternative. By subscribing to our channel, you'll have access to chapter wise, comprehensive book summaries that delve into the smart ideas presented in those books. Thanks for watching. More wisdom, more solution, better life.